Good evening, and welcome to the sound of 007 in concert at the Royal Albert Hall.
Stroke it and address it.
James Bond composer and producer of tonight's wonderful concert, David Arnold. Yeah.
Celebration of 60 years of James Bond movies, and particularly the music. Like the Bond films, we wanted to start with something spectacular, something thrilling, and in this case, a musical one, courtesy of the Queen of the Bond songs, Dame Shirley Bassey, yeah. Showing us
with love, Jamie Cullum.
from Russia with love. I fly to you, much wiser since my goodbye to you. I've traveled the world to learn. I must return from Russia with love. I've seen faces, places, and smiled for a moment, but oh, you haunted me so. Still my tongue tied, young pride would not let my love for you show. In case you'd say no to Russia, I flew, but then suddenly knew you'd care again. My running around is through. I fly to you from Russia. Thank you.
And now, an original Bond recording artist, Lulu, sings The Man with the Golden Gun.
Hey, hey, hey. welcome to the stage performing Skyfall, Emma Lindau.
Oh,
Now, please welcome Celeste, singing You Only Live Twice.
Thank you.
License to Kill.
once I get my sights on you, I've got a license to kill, and you know I'm going straight for yours. I've got a license to kill, and you want to price me till it's a license to kill.
Please welcome to the stage, performing their title song from the film The World Is Not Enough, Garbage.
I know how to heal. Don Black, lyricist Don Black.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. It takes a lot of people and a lot of hard work to organize such a wonderful evening like this. One man has been steering the ship all the way. I don't think he slept for 3 months. And he is the talented and tireless David Arnold. John Barry received 5 Oscars and many other glittering prizes. But even if he won the Nobel Peace Prize, he would still be known today as the man who created the music for James Bond. Someone like John Barry comes along once in a lifetime, and I'm very lucky he came along in mine. I'm very proud to say that I was his closest friend. When I first met him, he was also a bit like James Bond himself. He even had the same initials. He drove a white Maserati, he wore handmade suits,
He had a fabulous bachelor apartment overlooking the Thames. He was successful, handsome and famous. I don't know what those women saw in him. He liked to eat in good restaurants, and he was very fussy about what he drank. Only the best was good enough for John. It had to be Dom Perignon champagne, Stolichnaya vodka, Pellini Montrachet wine, Delamain brandy. And then we'd have lunch. John didn't eat much at these lunches. In fact, I don't remember one meal when a waiter didn't say to him, "Is everything all right, Mr. Barry?" When Michael Caine presented him with an award, he said, "This is the first time I've presented an award that is heavier than the recipient." John lived in America for over 40 years, but he remained a Yorkshireman through and through. Not once did I ever hear him say any of those overused American phrases like "go figure" or "I don't have any issues with that." He never used words like "awesome" or "closure." And I always felt that John put the York in New York. Writing songs with John was an absolute joy, and really very easy. We never wrote in the same room. He liked to take his time and think a lot about his melodies. When I finally got one, it was always worth waiting for. He wasn't comfortable writing with what he called pop people. When he worked on The Living Daylights with the Norwegian group A-ha, he said it was like playing table tennis with four balls. Our collaboration was more like a marriage. And like a wonderful marriage, it was too short. Unfortunately for John and for everyone else, you only live once.
Please welcome the composer of No Time to Die, Hans Zimmer.
Thank you.
please give a big welcome to Skin performing Live and Let Die. David Arnold with You Know My Name.
I'll just say a few words before we do this song. On May the 18th, 2017, we lost one of the legends of rock music, Mr. Chris Cornell. Sometimes in this business, the best you can hope for is you remain friends with the people that you work with. Chris became a very close friend, and his loss shocked us all a huge amount. We wrote the song together for Casino Royale, and I always thought I'd never want to hear anyone else sing it, but I didn't want to exclude it from tonight. So in memory of our dear friend Chris, I hope he'll forgive me. I'm gonna sing You Know My Name. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Performing GoldenEye, Paloma Faith.
the girls, they gather around him. If I had him, I wouldn't let him out. Golden dye, not lace, not leather. Golden chains, take him to the spot. Golden dye, I'll show him forever. It'll take forever to see what I got. You never know how I watch you from the shadows of a child. You never know how it feels to get so close and break the night. It's a golden honey trap I got for you tonight. Revenge is a kiss I won't miss. Now I've got you in my soul.
to the stage performing Nobody Does It Better from The Spy Who Loved Me, Ella Eyre.
Thank you.
singing All the Time in the World.
To unfold all the precious gifts, love.